People in the northern suburb of Chicago are on alert. That's because an American buffalo has been spotted in fields in western Lake and eastern McHenry counties.
The 850-pound buffalo has been roaming. I didn't write that. Essentially a buffalo loner. Oh man, they keep going. Since she escaped her farm in Wauconda back in September.
That farm was the Milk and Honey Farmstead. And joining us now is the owner, Scott Comstock, and his business partner, Sunny Kreisha. Welcome.
Hi, thanks.
Hello.
We have to start with the most important question, because this bison has been referred to multiple times, different outlets, not us, I don't think, as Tyson the Bison. Is that your bison's name?
No, it is not. That was a name given by the media. We don't know why. She has not been named. We're hoping to have a naming when she comes back home. A little contest, not a contest, but a name picking for her when she gets back.
So walk us through it. How did this happen? How did we get to this point where people have just been spotting the animal around town in the area?
I made the great decision to purchase a couple of bison for educational purposes here on the farm.
Okay.
And while we were unloading them, we weren't on the same page, and the first one that got out, and I chased her up into the forest and the preserve, and then down Highway 176.
Oh no!
And so now during rush hour, also mind you, so pretty tough to keep it under wraps when it's running down 176 during rush hour.
Yeah, so. No joke. I understand that she's also on the younger side, too, and as you just mentioned, new to the farm, so she probably isn't just used to all of the happenings at Milk and Honey.
No, she came from northern, up by Green Bay, where, you know, there's nothing but pasture and wide open space to the northern suburbs of Chicago, so I'm sure she's got a little bit of adjusting to do.
Mm. So help us paint the picture. Why isn't it as easy as going to get the animal, putting it back? It just doesn't work that way, right? And what are you telling people who do happen to see it and spot it? What's the message for them?
Well, it's not a cow, so it won't be herded. It's only going to go where it wants to go. So is why I'm waiting for the snow to fly, so the feed becomes more scarce, and we can track her and hopefully bait her into a building and then close it up and then load her up and bring her home. Mm.
And you guys have sent along a little bit of video here of our not yet named bison. Let me pull that up. I know it's not the greatest video, but it's funny because it kind of works with the whole, we're searching for this bison that has just been seen spotted around the northwestern suburbs up there. Is there anything specific, though, that you could tell us about her? Something that identifies her or describes her, maybe foods that bison like that could be put out to attract her so that people could then call the sheriff's office?
Well, it's mostly alfalfa, higher protein grasses, and, you know, a little bit of vegetables. Like her sister that we have here on the farm, I've just now gotten her to start eating celery and carrots and what have you. So mostly alfalfa. A good high protein alfalfa will get her to stop and eat.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, I forgot to have you guys introduce the other friend that's joining you guys on the screen there. Obviously, it just goes to show you guys are on site with all the animals.
Yeah, this is Dave. Dave came to us. A little girl took an egg home from our chicken coop, and she hatched it in her closet, and her mom found it.
Wow.
And, heard it chirping one night, went in there and here she had hatched an egg in her closet. And so they brought it, and she had it for a couple of months in her closet. And so this is actually a full-grown chicken that never got very full-grown. So, she brought him to the farm, and we named him Dave, but since he was always in the house, we put him outside and he runs right in the door. You can't keep him out of the house. So. So now he just, it's a she, but, her name is Dave.
Dave.
That is awesome. And for people who aren't too familiar with your farm, talk to us about what you guys do and what you guys specialize in.
Oh, well, we specialize in lots of things. We are chemical free. That's our thing here. We try to be you know, healthy, do things the old school way. Our vegetables, you know, no chemicals, no additives, no preservatives. That's nice. What we do. Our meat is grass fed, free range. So that's what we try to do here, going back to the way things used to be. Right.
Wow. That's awesome.
We're trying to grow things that are good for your immune system, your thyroid, central nervous system. That so many people come to us that have some type of a food allergy or an autoimmune deficiency or something like that, that they can't eat this, that, and the other thing. So we've gotten to be known for getting them what they need, the type of food that they need to help build their immune system.
Wow.
Now, with our missing bison, to go back to that, there's a little bit of lightheartedness happening along with it. I mean, on one hand, it is a fairly serious thing. You have a larger animal wandering in a fairly densely populated area that is new to the area as well. But at the same time, it's not like it's a dangerous predator who's out there hunting at this point. I bring all that up to set up a Facebook post. You may have seen or heard of this one by the Lake County Sheriff's Office. I'll bring it up here. Where they, in their turn, are also having some fun. And I'll tell you, the comments are all about the author. If you guys haven't seen this, anybody out there, I'll read it to you real quick. This is no bull. Actually, it's an American buffalo, fondly given the name Tyson the Bison, which we now know is incorrect. And she's still on the move as she fled from her familiar surroundings in September. She continues to graze across Western Lake and Eastern McHenry counties. Tyson means, you know, farm. We hoof talked to the owners who are hoping for a snowfall, as you guys mentioned, so they can track her and take her into custody safely. You won't be able to wrangle her with your hand calves, and she can be a bit impulsive if you see her. Please don't approach her. You can call your local police agency, and we will call the owners, that's these guys, for a smooth apprehension. What is your take on this write-up, both communicating that good information, but also having a little bit of fun with it?
I think it's great.
I never read that. That's the first time I read that. That's absolutely fantastic.
Oh, that's wonderful. And it's true. She's doing just fine. So, you know, don't have to worry about her. She's happy in this environment. And as long as, you know, just be cautious and let her be.
Yeah.
And we'll hopefully get her home soon.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, Scott and Sunny, is there anything else you'd like to add or you'd like people to know about the missing animal or just in general, any message you'd like to send out?
Well, you can always come to the farm and see her sister and our other various animals at the farm. We do have a little farm store here. We're open from 10 to 5, Wednesday through Sunday, and please come on down and say hello.
Nice pitch.
Okay. Well, we hope that the sisters are reunited soon, as we've got a message at the bottom of the screen there for anybody that does spot our yet-to-be-named bison. Do not approach. Simply call Lake County Sheriff's Office or your local police agency, and they will be able to help. Oh, what was it? Hand calf, hurt, wrangle, whatever the Lake County Sheriff's came up with.
Whatever that was.
Yeah. Well, Sunny and Scott, we thank you guys for taking the time and getting the Zoom set up to join us here on WGN News Now. And we do hope that you're able to reclaim your lost baby girl.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, you guys.